Ms. Dixon, principal of McLeod, thank you so much for joining us. And it is 6:05, and as promised, we are going to get started with our summer reading. I'm so excited. I absolutely love, 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 love summer reading. Let me just first preface this by saying that originally this was a secondary session. So we may have, some secondary people with a secondary focus on here. However, we just said, guess what? If you didn't get a chance to come on Tuesday, that's fine. Just come on. Come on over to Thursday, and we'll make sure that we accommodate you. So I just want to let you all know this will just be a general pre-K through 12 session today. So even when we present, Ms. Kelly may show you an upper grade, a secondary example, we'll still be able to show you how it can apply to all grade levels. We have some very interesting things. So we're just going to go ahead, jump in and get started. We're going to share our screen. We're going to go ahead and get started with summer reading. We've entitled it a summer reading bake-off because we are integrating reading with baking for this specific focus. All right, next slide. All right, so our summer reading committee, that's everyone that has been involved in this entire process. Ms. Whittington is on here. She's our lead librarian. She leads all of this summer reading, the partnerships, the kickoffs, the everything. My name is Siobhan Loretta McDuffie Otis. However, I just go by the name of Mac O. That is just what people call me. Makes everything easier. And I'm happy with that. I work in the Office of School Support, managing Freckle AR, my aunt, a little bit of school status, and working heavily with Team 2, Ms. Woody, being the assistant superintendent. All right, here we go. Summer reading. Here's our mission and our vision. We want to make sure that we provide a guided reading list to engage all scholars. We want children to be able to, yes, read the district selected book for the grade level, as well as read what you want to read. We're trying to build strong and independent readers, and we definitely encourage summer reading. Okay. So next, what we did was we had our team together. We got our team together and we created a summer reading video. Usually we'll have a kickoff by going to a different school site and having like a summer reading pep rally. This year, we did a summer reading video. Now, I don't know if any of you all have seen the video. We've tried to share it on social media or what have you. If you have not seen the video, we are getting ready to show it now. And then when it's over, we want you to go on YouTube. We want you to watch it. And then we want you to send that link and share it with all of your aunts, your uncles, your cousin Pookie, your church members, your sorority, your fraternity, all your community members, because we want a lot of views, because we are trying to really spread summer reading in Jackson Public Schools. And so here it goes. Take a look. We're getting ready to introduce our summer reading.
Hey, I'm Tamara Sheree, midday personality for 97.7 The Beat of the Capitol, and television personality for Bell Collective on the OWN Network. Also, JPS Summer Reading Ambassador. Welcome one and all to the very exciting Jackson Public Schools 2021 Summer Reading Palooza. This summer's reading expectations are: all scholars are required to read a district selected book and complete a reading log. All students must choose two additional titles and complete a reading log. The goal is for all scholars to read at least three books, but we certainly encourage more. All district selected books will remain the same as the previous years. Please see your school's librarian and visit the JPS website at www.jackson.k12.ms.us for more information. Now, let's get ready to dive into some books. Read on, Jackson.
Lego. Strategy game. Face side to the face, don't strip on your legs. Mouth, Burn away our carbon beam, knock your legs off. Try to get away from me. Had to stand off, hit him in the spine. Knock his dreads off, my words is called a body. I didn't name them random offs, dugging in my Reeboks. Ride with a G-Shock, I heard he shot. Truckles make a beat box. He made a shot turn, wore the spot off, built a car.
We filmed a video to promote summer reading, encouraging young people to continue their reading, to choose books that they're interested in, not necessarily the ones that we require of them, but if you want to know something more about chemistry or whales or cars or athletes or dance, whatever that is, there are all kinds of books out there. And so lots of opportunities for young people, well, not just young people, for all of us to read and to explore our interests and to sharpen our skills.
In Miami with my heat, let's see how the feet are. I walk in the party, I'm on my big boom, ready to get it started. I got no sense, no heat of blood. Ride around with fuck, call me Kobe. 24, can't fuck with her no more. Gotta do the most. I get in groove on every time I see them folks. I got that on the door, thinking that's something you need to know. I'm smooth and I'm cold. No, my wrist on froze with a big bang roll. I didn't name no random mouse. Dugging in my Reeboks. Ride with a G-Shock. I heard he shot. Turkle make a big box. He made a shot turn. Wore the spot off, built a car. Had a mask. Turkle make a big box.
Right on, Jackson.
So next, we have the summer reading requirements. All right, so here, as was stated in the video, we're asking for all students to read at least three books, all right, at least three books, and complete a reading log. Each grade level will have a specific book that they need to read and do the reading log, and then they can choose any other two books that they want to read. Can a child read more? Absolutely. Absolutely read more. As long as that child completes a reading log to go along with that, then that child will get a lot of credit for it. Okay. We are in the process now of preparing incentives and awards for any high readers or, you know, it's kind of specific awards. But the main thing we want is for your children to just read as much as possible. And we know that children benefit when they see parents reading. And so that was honestly something even with me that I had to improve upon as a parent, is that my children didn't see me reading. Because a lot of time if I'm reading, I mean, they of course they see me reading their homework, but things that I need to read, they were not seeing that. I'm reading a lot at work. If I'm reading a dissertation, let's say, I'm reading it at night when they're asleep. So a lot of times there, so I had to really be conscious about reading in front of my children, okay? And that's kind of something that we need to do. All right, next slide. These are our district required books. Now, a lot of times teachers will tell me that they kind of get confused as to what book the child needs. This means that if your child will be this grade in August. So in August, if your child will be a kindergartner, then that child needs to read now, or for the summer, Pete the Cat, I Love My White Shoes. First grade, Lily's Purple Plastic Purse. Second grade, Officer Buckle and Gloria. Third grade, The Story Julian Tells. Fourth grade, Frindle. And fifth grade, The Mighty Miss Malone. These are the books for the traditional schools. However, if your child is in an advanced academic school and goes to Obama, Casey, or Wales APAC, your children will need to read the following books: The Itsy Bitsy Spider, Where the Wild Things Are, The Firekeeper's Son, Rocks a Boxin', The Sasquatch Escape, and The Lion Who Stole My Arm. Okay, so here's the thing, these books have not changed. Sixth grade, we have Wonder. Seventh grade, Monster. And eighth grade, Secret Lies and Algebra. For advanced academics, they will have Fish in a Tree, A Long Walk to Water, and Black Boy, okay? And then we also have on the screen the traditional books for high school, traditional books for high school, and then the advanced academic books for high school are those on the screen, and you see two or three for each grade, depending on if that child is in AP classes or IB. So it just kind of all depends. But the entire list is on our JPS website under the summer reading tab, okay? And here's the thing. We've had these books for a couple of years now. This is the last year of these titles, the last year. So that's why we wanted to go out with a bang. Next school year, next summer, we will have different titles. We started already in the process of getting books, doing suggestions, looking at lexile levels, looking at multicultural ramifications of it. So we want to just kind of make sure that this year with these titles, we're going out with a bang. So here are our books, okay? All right, let's see, next slide. So ideas for summer reading. Here's the thing we want you all to kind of look at. When you are developing or doing summer reading with your children, here are some cute little things I would suggest. Choose a theme. So instead of just randomly picking books, maybe you can say, hey, let's read about animals this summer. Maybe June fiction, maybe July nonfiction. Maybe let's do an author study. So maybe the whole summer, you're reading Mark Brown books or Bernstein books or Kevin Hinks books or Kadir Nelson, just a list of books, James Patterson books. It just kind of all depends. Maybe you want to go with the religious focus. Maybe you're having vacation Bible school and you want to read about those different parables in the Bible. Maybe you want to do sports. Maybe the whole summer your child is doing a baseball camp. Maybe let's read about baseball, or maybe this week baseball, this week lacrosse, this week bowling, whatever. Maybe you want to do a music focus. Maybe 1 week you do sports, 1 week you do music, 1 week you do dinosaurs, and just kind of ask your children what they like. You may decide to do a fairy tale study. Go from Goldilocks and the Three Bears to the Three Billy Goats Gruff to Cinderella. I mean, it's endless. And so with me, I generally like to do this. I like to have a theme with my children. And I remember I was thinking about when I was around 8 years old, my grandmother used to get ready for work. And she would have her little radio, turn that radio on. And all of a sudden, I thought about when I was 8 and the song came on the radio saying, "Been around the world and now, yeah, yeah, I can't find my baby." I got so tired of that song. But as I thought about it, I was like, oh, that's it. That's my summer reading thing, been around the world. So my children and I read books from Asia and Africa and North America and South America and Europe and books from those different continents. Then we also looked at the cooking, you know, the foods. Now, I didn't taste all those dishes that we cooked, but we cooked, and then we looked at the music and we looked at the culture and all different types of aspects related. So it wasn't just about reading a book. It was also like, well, how can I extend that book? Because I'm trying to make it fun. I'm trying to get in depth with it, okay? You can explore different genres. Maybe your child loves graphic novels, or biographies, or mystery, or urban drama. It just kind of all depends. Maybe, again, like I said before, maybe your child wants to do a book series and read all of the Harry Potter books. Or maybe the child wants to read, after the regular book, The Coldest Winter Ever, and then maybe read Midnight. Just kind of all depends how you all want to innovate summer reading. We also have some resources for parents that we have available here on May 26th. Scholastic is having a parent night. So you can go on Facebook and attend that. Scholastic has a summer reading program. And then make sure if you're on a computer, you take a screenshot or get your phone, because we will be presenting a lot of this. Now, we do have it recorded and we will, you know, kind of have that posted. But if you want something quick and easy, just take a picture of all of this. Reading Rockets, it has a lot of great parent resources. And I like at the end where we have create electronic fun ways. So maybe after a child has written a reading log, well, then we can go into making a flip grid about it. Okay. Or maybe doing a TikTok video about summer reading. Okay. So here, those are some different resources that we have. Next slide. Okay, so as your child is reading with the reading logs, because when I say reading logs, I'm talking about find a book, your child goes through reading that book, you may want to ask some questions about the book, and then it's time to write about it. The last thing that we want is for your child to just write what's on the back. And we get that. And we have wonderful librarians that are going through actually reading those reading logs. Say, oh, that one's not going to count. That was not going to count. We don't want the child to just write, okay, what's on the back. We want the child to just, in their own words, tell what that book was about, okay? Now, sometimes I'll go a little bit extra. And for my children, I have them to do two paragraphs. First paragraph is generally what it's about, and it doesn't even have to be that long because I'm more concerned in your reflection, your reaction to it. So while you were reading, describe what you pictured in your mind. What comes as a surprise in the book? The most exciting thing I learned from this book is blah, 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 okay? So that's more of an interaction. It's kind of like when you all watch some of your TV shows. I know a lot of you all, you probably at home sometime when Scandal was on, watching Scandal or what's that other stuff, Game of Thrones. Let me tell you, what's that show that people are talking about? What people want? Love and Hip Hop, all those the different little shows. You know, I'm pretending like I don't know what it is, what the name of it. Okay, the Housewives of Atlanta and all that kind of stuff. You know, it's one thing to just tell, well, what happened. But it's more so, you know, to get with your friends and say, girl, did you see what happened? Now, so-and-so should not have done that because I remember when I was in that situation. See how you're making a text to self-connection. Yeah, because over in so-and-so or in this other book, I remember that because in this other book, that's what happened. I'm making a text to text connection. So it's more so in the interaction and the reflection. So you may have your child to just kind of maybe use some of these guiding questions to just kind of help and assist when your child is trying to write the reading log. So just kind of make it fun and interesting for them. Okay. All right. Next slide. So here are our reading logs and examples. Again, like we stated, on the JPS website, we have the summer reading program. We have the books, we have events, we have the required books. And over there on the right-hand side, as you can see, right under our Read on Jackson logo, there are our reading logs. And you can pull up the PDF for K through 2, for 3 through 5, and for 6 through 12. And you all can just, you know, have your child to either type in it or write on it. Okay. Now, do you have to have a district sheet off of this site in order to turn a reading log? Absolutely not. If you don't want to do that, listen, go get a good old clean sheet of notebook paper and have your child write their title, write the author, and then write the reflection. Boom, you good. That's all that you need. We don't have to go in depth. Some of you all may want to type, make it look pretty, whatever. That's fine. Now, me, I'm not going to tell a story. I go all out now for summer reading. I go get a binder. I go print out my sheets. I make sure I put my lines on. I get a ruler. I put lines on it. I go put my child's name on it. I make a copy. I punch holes in it. Sometimes I make a copy, and then I have different colors of sheets. So I have maybe 10 purple and 10 pink. So see, I have different genres, you know, different things going on. Now, again, I'm extra. You don't have to do all of that. I told you all, I love summer reading. Not more than I love the Casey and JoJo, Davin and Devontae. Not more than that, but I do. Miss Campbell, yes, ma'am, indeed. Yes, I did say that I love Jodeci. My son's middle name is Devontae. I love him so much. But anyway, that's how I do with summer reading. But we also have a digital version that Miss McQueen will kind of model and just kind of show for you all. But I did want to share with you all that we do have the summer reading logs on our summer reading program page on our Jackson Public Schools website. Okay. All right, next.
Hello.
All right, next slide. So now that I have told you all about the actual requirements of the book and what we need to do with the book, we're gonna now model. And so I'm gonna pass the torch over to the fabulous Miss McQueen, and she's gonna model for you all this little summer reading process.
Good evening, everyone. Okay, using a digital resource, we are going to show you how your child can access books as well as complete a digital version of the reading log. Next slide. Okay, so of course we want you to visit your local library if you can this summer. However, your child does have access to digital libraries on Clever via the jpsms.org website. So your child has a username and password, and if you're not sure what it is, you can contact the school. They log into Clever, and the district has all of these fabulous resources where they can actually go and read books. So for example, we have Mac and Via, Sora, and My Own. These are all digital libraries with over 6,000 digital books that can be read this summer. So the one we're gonna use tonight is My Own. So once your child logs on to Clever, they'll see the district apps and they just click the My Own icon. Next slide. All right, once they log on to My Own, you will see the library homepage. On this page, you can search for a book depending on the theme. You can do a certain grade level, a certain genre of text, whatever it is that your child is looking for. So to go with our theme tonight, we are going to search the topic bread and find a book about bread tonight for our theme. So you can stop sharing, Mrs. Weaverton, and I'll share my screen. Okay, so log on to Clever again. Click the My Own app. It's going to load, and I'll just go to Library so I can search or browse for the book I want. All right, and it's telling you the different topics that you can choose from. So you can just hit the search button, and we are gonna type in bread for tonight and hit the search button again. So the book we are going to do tonight is Bread Around the World. Now, what I suggest you have your scholar do before even reading is getting some important information that they are going to need to put on their reading log. So you can use the front cover of the book. If you think that's too small, they can click this blue info button. If you click the blue info button, it'll give you an overview of the book. It'll show recommended grade levels. Two things that they absolutely need for the reading log. One, the title needs to go on the reading log. So of course you will have them write Bread Around the World for what we're gonna do tonight. Next, they need to have the author's name. As you can see, it's kind of small to really look at from the picture of the front cover of the book. So you can just click this I for details, and it tells you that the author of this book is Helen Gregory. So that too needs to go on the reading log. So remember, author and title of the book. Once they have this information, they can just press the green read button. And I'm gonna start over. I actually read the book. All right, and we'll quickly go through it. So they can play the book, we'll either read it to them, or they can just go through and read it. So it tells you people around the world eat bread. Some bread is baked in a metal oven. Some bread is baked in a clay oven. Some bread is fried in a pan. Some bread is steamed in a basket. Bread comes in many shapes and sizes. Some bread is round. Some bread is shaped like the moon. Some bread has a hole in the middle. Some bread is tied in a knot. Some bread is flat and crunchy. Some bread is flat and soft. This bread wraps around food. This bread has a pocket. Everyone eats bread. So when your child comes to talk to you about a book, like Dr. McOl suggested, make those text to real world connections. You know, you can ask them, what dishes do you like that have bread? What were some familiar types of bread that you saw when reading the book? Just to kind of guide them to make sure they have an understanding and grasp what they read. And that way, it'll make it a little bit easier when they go to do their reading log. All right, so once they read it and you all have discussed, you can go to the JPS website, pull up the reading log. Give me a second, I'm gonna move this out of the way. All right, so you go to the website, pull up the reading log, like Dr. McOl just showed you, website, you download the reading log, and it's gonna pop up if you wanna do it digitally. Now, using your Chromebook computer, there is actual software where you can download this PDF and type in it. If you don't wanna type in it, writing it is perfectly fine. All right, so we're gonna download, this is the one for K2, and we're gonna see what it should look like based on the book we just ventured through. So of course you're gonna want your child to write their name. Again, title and author, that needs to go on there. For K2, they'll draw a picture about their book. So they may draw the bread with the hole, a muffin, a loaf of bread. They may make a real world connection and draw cake because they related to bread. After they draw their picture, they'll just write about it. Again, make sure they are not copying directly from either the hard copy book or the digital book. We want them to be able to tell in their own words what the picture is about and how it relates to the book that they read. Okay, so once you fill out your digital copy of the reading log, you can save it to your computer. There will be a link that you can access that's gonna take you to Google Form. When you get to that Google Form, it's gonna have either the pre-K2 summer reading log or 3-5. Again, this can also be accessible through your child's Clever. So once you get into Clever, if you wanna do it digitally, you really won't have to leave that platform. Everything will be there that you need. You'll type in the child's name, the school, grade level, and here's a checklist. This checklist relates back to those guiding questions that you wanna ask either before, during, and after, really, after your child reads the book. Normally, 2-5, they won't need you to ask them these guiding questions. They'll be able to really read and go through them by themselves. But if you wanna just engage in conversation and let them tell you about the book, reading these questions or using these questions, that's absolutely perfectly fine. All right, so you will just check, or your scholar can check the questions that they use to complete the reading log or write the summary. Again, they'll put the title of the book. Now, this is the part that I love. After they complete this digitally and you save it to the computer, you just hit this add file. You're gonna select the file from the device you're on, check the little box by the reading log, click open, and it attaches to this form. Once you upload it and it's completed, you can just let it upload. It'll show you that it's attached. Once this information is filled out, you just hit this blue submit button and you turned in the first reading log. Now, the downloadable version on our website does have more than one page where you can put multiple books, which is fine as well. If your child wants to use just this one document to do several books or several copies to do more books, that's absolutely fine. But just know you can only upload one document per Google form. So for example, if your child reads 5 books, do them all on this one form. You can upload this one form once you save it to the Google form sheet or this digital form to fill out. Then they read another 5 books. You can just download it again, fill it out, and do the same process. So you won't have to worry about all that paper, losing papers, being like Dr. McGill, getting you binders to go take to the school. It'll go directly to who it needs to go to if you decide to use the digital platform.
I can hear you, Ms. Kelly. Go ahead.
Okay, I'll go ahead. As Dr. McGill was talking about the summer reading logs, I just want to show you guys what they're going to look like, what it's supposed to look like. Now, I will highly encourage that you all download it and print it because it'll actually allow for your child, you know, some direction. However, like she said, you don't have to do it. But let me first show you what it's supposed to look like. So I'm going to screen share real quick. Share my screen and go. Okay. When you go to the JPS website, you're going to see this. It's going to say directions for summer reading log. Now, Miss Kelly is a realist. When we see all of this, we're like, oh, this too much. And 9 times out of 10, children are going to flip through this and then they're going to go straight to the reading log. Let's just be, and parents too, especially if you all have been working all day, y'all don't want to do homework. I get it. So I want you all to share this tidbit with your friends who have students in JPS. All this is saying is they want you to read the book, have the child read the book, think about what they read, and then at the very bottom in number 3, it says, please indicate what type of book they read, whether it's fiction or nonfiction. Now, this 1 through 12 in the middle is simply reflection statements to help your child write their reflection or their summary of the book. I want to point out one thing, starting with number 5, you see it says informational text. I've had several parents that ask me, what is that? Y'all, informational text is simply nonfiction. We know fiction equal fake. Nonfiction equal not fake, which is the same thing as informational text. So I don't want you to get scared or have children get scared when they see informational text. They should be familiar with that jargon, but if they're not, it's just simply nonfiction. Now, when they read their book, to help them to be able to express themselves, because we've seen, and you guys probably know, when you ask your children, well, explain this to me or explain it to me, they really have trouble finding their words. It's just real. These are statements that are supposed to help them to express themselves. Now, let me say this. Please don't try to have your child answer all, if they're reading a book that's fiction, please don't try to have them to answer all the questions that are fiction. They don't have to do that. In my example that I'm about to show you, I took the first 3. And whichever ones you want to, if you want to pick 1 and 2, or if you just want to pick number 1, it's completely up to you. We just want them to be able to express themselves. So let me show you what it looks like. First, I did summer reading log for grades 6 through 12 because I'm a middle division. I'm grade 6 through 8. So you put the student's name. You see her name is Ashanti Super Student. This is her first book she's reading, and the title of the book is The Bully. Let me tell all parents, especially parents of boys, the Bluford series books, I have noticed as a middle school teacher for more than a decade, the Bluford series books captures the boys' attention because there are several different books that they can relate to in the Bluford series, and The Bully is one of them. So, summary or reflection. I'm going to go down here first where it says questions, because what the district actually wants you to do is they want you to notate which questions did you answer. So all I did was copy and paste the questions that I was going to answer in my reflection. First question says, identify the source of the conflict in the story and how the conflict shapes the characters through the story and their response to the conflict. Well, right here for question one in the first paragraph, this looks like a lot, but if y'all notice, you know, we were taught old school, paragraphs have to be 5 to 7 sentences. Now, that's out the window. All they want you to do is to be able to thoroughly respond to the question. So, question one, what's the conflict in the story? How did it shape the character? The conflict is Daryl is moving. His friend who normally, because he's a little bitty boy, his best friend normally protects him against bullies. He's scared of moving because he's scared he's going to get picked on and his best friend is going to stay back in California. And so that's the conflict. The second question asks, how did the main character change over the course of the story? Well, guess what? Of course, the main character moved to a new city, new school. He started getting bullied. So I answer question two in 3 different paragraphs. I started off by saying, well, you know, Jason moved next door to his mama's brother. And he noticed his big cousins who were boys. One, the bigger cousin was messing with the little cousin and he didn't like it because he knew what it felt like to get bullied. So that made him feel some type of way. He tried to tell his uncle. His uncle got mad and was like, oh, they just boys, leave them alone. And then one day he went to school and his teacher gave him a book called Hatchet. And he read Hatchet. And Hatchet taught you how to have self-confidence, self-esteem, how to defend yourself without being aggressive. And he read that book. And he became empowered by that book. He's like, okay, I can do this. Question three says, identify the key moments in the story and how they relate to the story's thing. Well, the key moment, everybody knows when you're talking about a bully, what happens in the end? The good, the protagonist defeats the antagonist. So Daryl, he got his courage up. He stood up to Teray, who was the bully. They got, like the kids say, they got to fighting. And the bully's wrist got broken. He found a new, he had a newfound confidence and he gained the respect of his peers. I answered all three of those questions and look at my summary. Each paragraph was maybe 1 to 2 sentences. So I don't want your children or you to feel like, oh, we got to write a 10-page paper. You don't have to do that. Just pick what question, I would say at least 2. So that you can give their writing some depth and so that you can help them with their writing. This is one thing I do want to encourage parents to do. I see there are a lot of elementary parents on here, and elementary parents are extremely enthusiastic and hands-on with their children. But when they get to middle school and high school, they're a little bit more hands-off. So if I have middle and high school parents on here, I need you to please read with your children. Now, Mrs. Kelly is not naive to the fact that you all are really trying to recover from COVID. So if your job is giving you extra hours, if you can make some side money somewhere, that's what you are trying to do. So let me give you some tips on how to ensure that your child has read the book. First, ask them, what are the additional books that you're reading? Once they tell you, y'all, when I tell you, all you have to do is Google the title of the book and Google, you know, test questions to ask about, let's just say, the bully, or text questions to ask about the book Hatchet. You can go on the internet, ask your children these particular questions. If they can't answer those questions, guess what? They did not read the book. Or if they say, Mama, I did read the book. Jenny Parks, if your baby say, I did read the book, and you say, okay, tell me about it. If by the time your baby finished and you don't feel like you read the book, they ain't read the book. And that's just real. Because if they read the book, they're going to give you significant details, insignificant details, and they're going to be able to tell you what happened from beginning to end. So as a means to help you all, just know that you can go to the internet and find questions on the internet with the answers so that you know the answers. Even if you didn't actually read the book, you can still fake with them and be like, you didn't read the book, because the answer is incorrect. No, son, you didn't read the book. And they won't have a clue. So I do know that your time is valuable. It is precious. And y'all don't always have time to sit down with your children. But it's very important. If you can read with them, you all, please, please, please read with them. They have lost so much over the last almost 2 years, like seriously. And we need them engaged. We need them reading. because we need to continue pouring into them how to express themselves, not just verbally, but on paper. Okay, I'm off my soapbox with that. Let me show you now, Dr. McOh, she showed you how to get to it, but let me just show you again. When you go to, can y'all see that I'm on the Jackson Public Schools website? Can y'all see that or no? Thumbs up if you can see. You can't see it? Okay. Let me stop sharing and then let me start sharing again. Right here. Here we go. If you're trying to find a summer reading log, you're going to go to the JPS website. You're going to click on schools. If you see over here at on the left-hand side, it says summer reading program. You're going to click on that. Once you click on summer reading program, like she showed you, it's going to be over here on the right-hand side, summer reading logs, and that's where it is. And it shows you exactly what I just showed you. Now, for those parents who do want to do it digitally and upload it, there's going to be a link on the website, and I'm going to show you how to submit it. Y'all, when I tell you it's so easy, it's going to be better than trying to have your children keep up with paper that they for books they read in June and July, and they're gonna be like, Mama, I don't know what I did with it, and y'all gonna be fussing. So after they finish doing it, just have them to upload it to the website. Hold on one second, here we go. And I want to show you what it's going to look like and how easy it's going to be. Can everybody see where it says virtual parent summer reading workshops? Thumbs up if you can see it. Y'all see it? Okay. So this is it. You just put the parent's name, your phone number, email address, school, grade, your child's name. And guess what? At the very bottom, it's going to say, hold on, let me move. Hold on. No, this ain't it. It's the Miss Wizardson. Help me kill it out. It's the one where it's going to say upload. It's going to look like this, y'all, but at the very bottom, I clicked on the wrong one. It's going to say upload. All you got to do is click upload if they did it on the computer and upload it. And that's it. But I'll have it step by step on the website so that you can do it. So that's pretty much it for me. That's what the log looks like. If you need a cheat sheet, all you got to do is Google the book that they're reading, find questions, and have them to talk to you about the book. If they can't explain it, they didn't read it. If you ask those questions and they can't answer those questions, they didn't read it. But y'all, please, please, please encourage your children to read this summer. Even if it's a small book, we don't care. We need them to read something because we need to have them to come back into school with a knowledge base of something. And we can work with that because they've lost so much from COVID and teachers only see them a certain amount of time a day. And we really, really need you all's help. Your friends, y'all have book clubs. Y'all go to the coffee shops, have book clubs at the coffee shop. Y'all go to the park and say, we're gonna have a book club or somebody at their house. We're gonna throw a pizza party. And you know what? We're gonna sit around and we're gonna read this book. Anything to make it interesting with their peers. But please, we really are begging y'all, please make sure your children read books. Okay, thank you all so very much. I'm done, Dr. McOh.
Thank you, thank you so much, Miss Kelly. Look, I'm still having some internet problems, but I'm gonna keep going. I'm on my phone because I told you all how I feel about summer reading. Ooh. I don't know if you all heard my child's middle name is Devontae, but I know that's the last part when it kind of cut me off. All right, so we're gonna go back to sharing our screen again, Miss Wissington, please. And now that Miss Kelly has shared with us about the actual summer reading logs, how now you can actually pull up the template. You can pull up the template and actually type inside of the template, or you can pull up the Google form, type the actual log in the Google form, and then just kind of send it. Now, your school, you may not know how to do this. This may frighten you. I will be honest. When they started talking to me and one of our librarians was sharing it, I was frightened. But then when I came back and I had it explained to me again, I said, oh, okay, I kind of understand. But here's the thing. You may not know how to do it, but your child may know exactly how to go in and attach and upload, and it's done because they've had to do that all year. Okay, so it may not be a big deal, but again, if you all don't want all of this Google form this and attach that, that's okay. Go ahead and get out your good old clean sheet of paper. We're completely fine with that. We do have various ways of how to assess books. Next slide, probably next two slides, next. All right, there are various ways that you can find a book. So besides going to the public library, we have various ways on how your child will still have access to Clever, and your child will still be able to do Freckle, even though that doesn't have anything to do with summer reading. But your child will be able to use My Aunt. My Aunt has a lot of wonderful books as well as news articles that your child can read. Your child can also check out books on Sora, and your child can also check books on Mac and Via. All of these apps are located on Clever. All you do is go in and click it, and it's open. And that's why we want to provide the icon. So if you've never heard of this before, take a picture of it and have your children to go inside of it to see exactly what's there. We all know that you all are familiar with AR, but that's just for, you know, taking quizzes, okay? So that's, so you can't say, oh, I don't have a book. We didn't get a chance to go to the library. Now, I still believe in going into the public library, but let's go ahead and have your children to actually read those books.
So now we have some actual book suggestions from our lovely librarians. So time to get your phones out. So if you need suggestions on books for your children, this is what the librarians have suggested, okay? K through two, here's some books here. The Bear Who Wasn't There, Llama Llama. All right. Next, here are some more from K2, pre-K through two. I absolutely love Hair Love. I absolutely love that book. Got that from my guy, baby. I absolutely love that book, Being Proud of Your Hair. All right. For three through five, here are some suggestions on here. I absolutely love Separate Is Never Equal. I keep that in my office. Tells about the story of how Mexican American children were not treated fairly and they had to have a Supreme Court case, kind of similar to Brown versus Board. So very good book. Look at all of these books we have for three through five. Here are some books that's available. May want to read that. And for our middle school, here are some books that your children may read. And when, honestly, when children get to middle school, they kind of taper off. They kind of think that reading may not be that cool. So we want to give them some books that maybe they can really enjoy, jump into. And for 9 through 12, oh my goodness, when it's time, when no children get to high school, it's almost like, listen, I am checking for nails, Jordans, lashes. I'm checking for working. I am not trying to check for a book. And I know this because I have a high school child that she is good. Summer reading will still be a part of her requirement. I like this book here, Slay. You know, because see, my thing to my child be, listen, you climb, you slay, you want to be all like, and I slay. Okay, you slay so much, slay with reading this book called Slay. That's what I want you to do, okay? All right. Some of you all said you have a popular book series that you like. So again, like we said before, maybe read all of the Brown Bear books. Read all of the If You Give a Pig a Pancake. You know, read that whole series there. Another popular series will be Amelia Bedelia, like someone said. That was their favorite book. Madeline, Curious George. Could be Molly Moon series. Ramona series. I know it's bringing you all back. And so at this point, we are almost, not fully, we're almost, a lot of you all, y'all stay with me. I'm coming. All right, we had questions and answers. We answered a lot of them in the chat. If not, this is our question and answer section. Does anyone have any questions that they would like to ask? Now, let me say this. Anything specific, you can always go to your child's teacher, your child's school librarian. You can always do that. You can always call Ms. Whittington here at the Teacher Resource Center. It is 601-960-8320.
You can call me. You can call me at 601-960-8892. Anytime, I'm always available. I love, love, love talking to parents. But now I'm going to open the floor. Are there any questions? And y'all don't leave yet because I got some at the end. Don't leave yet. Any questions? Okay. I don't have any questions. I like my professor say, any questions, any comments, any gossip, anything you got. Okay. So this is what I'm surprised for you all at the end. My phone had gone out. My phone's always going out, but it's back now. And so I want to share something with you all. Let me make sure everything is ready. See if y'all can hear this song here. Okay, thank you. That's what I'm talking about. Listen, everybody, I need the cameras on. I need the cameras on. I need to see y'all jumping for it. Where your camera? Come on. Oh, oh. Y'all, come on. I want to see y'all dancing. Come on, Miss Campbell. Come on. I want to see y'all do the Jumba. Where are my Jason best parents? We talking about summer reading. Do the Jumba. Hey. Y'all get low?
Jumba.
And you gotta make a little face. Make a little face.
Mr. Draper, I see your baby, Mr. Draper. Go on. Go ahead on, girl. Ew.
That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm saying. I see my baby back there. Look at you.
Uh-huh. Do it. Do that mouse, girl. Do that mouse.
See you,
that's
Mr.
right.
Tasha.
That's right.
Come on. Look, Dad, you better come on with him now, Miss Marquia. That's what I'm talking about.
He's just dabbed on you. Look at that baby in the back. I see you, you all.
Listen, like they say, ain't no mountain high enough, ain't no valley low enough to keep me away. My internet messed up. Ooh, I'm out of breath. I said, you know what? I'm going to run on across the street and come on over here to the Teacher Resource Center because I absolutely love summer reading. But I'm going to stop now, y'all, because I done got old now. Okay. All right, y'all. Thank you all so much for joining. I hope you all enjoyed this. I hope you learned about summer reading, and I hope you get your children reading. Call me, call your school, whatever y'all need. See y'all later. Bye.
Thank you, Mecca.
All right. Thank y'all so much. Goodbye, everyone. Thank you, Ms. Latham. Thank you for joining. Bye, Ms. Campbell. Bye, Mike Kennedy, my baby.